If you can think of it, you can probably customize it. That has always been the motto of Android ecosystem. And what's better way to customize Android than Android Launcher? So this is Mina from TechWiser.com. And since it's TechWiser, we won't be talking about some mainstream Android launchers such as Nova, Apex, or Action Launcher, etc. You know it, I know it. Rather, some little known Android launchers that has been recently released and deserve a lot more attention than they are getting. So let's begin. Okay, so first up we have the Ratio Launcher. I know, it's quite popular, but then again, it has to be on the list. Ratio is an ideal minimal and productivity launcher that you might already know. But here's what I like and how I use it. First of all, here's the first page of Ratio, where all the apps are present pre-organized, but you can obviously reorganize them into different drawers and folders. And what I love about this is gesture. Swipe down and hold, and then you get the entire app list. Also, the drawer shows you if there is any notification available with the color of the app for easy identification. Now swipe left, and here's where the interesting part lies. It basically looks like Google feed, but a lot better, minus the ads of course. It already has few options to choose from, like let's say if I want to know what's the weather quickly, I can have that. That's a simple task. But let's say if I want to stay updated with news from The Verge or any other outlet of your choice, then I can also do that as well. And now literally I have the list of articles from Verge. Plus I can read the entire article here, distraction free. Again, no ads anywhere. Now moving to the right, you have the space where all the messaging apps are sorted out. It only supports WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, Telegram at this moment. Unfortunately, there's no signal support as of now, but you can manage all the messages and everything from a single place. Seriously, it's one of the best minimal and productivity launcher out there. Now moving on to the next one. Next up we have Zenit Launcher, which is a pretty straightforward launcher and looks a lot like iPhone home screen. So similar to iPhone, you directly get to see the app drawer and a dock where you can pin applications, and long press on the application will give you a quick shortcuts. Now swiping right will give you the widget area where you can add as many widgets as possible. There's obviously a little bit of customizations like theme, changing icon packs, etc. The only reason this launcher is on the list is because of the way it's designed. So every time you unlock your phone, you will have to go through a plethora of applications just to find the app that you are looking for. For example, let's say if you want to open WhatsApp, there is no way to search for it. You just have to scroll down and down and down, and there you go. There is WhatsApp. See, my point is, if there are a lot of applications installed and by the time you get to your application, you will eventually lose interest in it. And that's exactly the point of this launcher. It makes it hard to find applications so that you don't overuse your phone. However, unlike iPhone, your home screen icon don't have to be divided into horizontal pages only. They can also be vertical scrolling like the standard Android app launcher. Or you can even switch to colorful card view layout. Up next we have Nova Launcher. But wait a sec, what is Nova Launcher doing here? Well, this is Nova Launcher Beta, which was recently released with many cool new features. Like you can swipe down to the app icon to assign a new app or a task to it. Earlier it only had swipe up gesture. So now this WhatsApp icon, if I tap on it, it opens WhatsApp obviously. And if I swipe up, it will open Telegram. And swipe down and it will open Signal. So I don't have to create a folder with many applications in it, which might also look ugly. Okay, so here's another one. The folder layout can now change to view in immersive format, and it also will have page view where you can scroll horizontally or vertically to get to more apps in the folder. And then there are a lot more small changes here and there that improve the visual as well as the customization experience. And yes, it feels a little bit smoother as well. Maybe placebo. Up next we have Letters Launcher, and the fact that the name literally represents the product, well, that's just amazing. So the launcher is basically a clear home screen with just letters, and tapping on a particular letter will open all the apps that start with that particular letter. The top portion is dedicated to widget, and you can only add one widget at a time, and that's what the application sells as well. Also, you can freely adjust the letters wherever you want in the bottom half, and then change few things like changing the color, changing the format, etc. Every time you open the application, it gets into the regular tab below, and then obviously you can disable it if you want. A nice wallpaper will really complement it and makes it stand out. Do try it out. If you're a calendar kind of a person and completing tasks give you dopamine rush, then this launcher is for you. So the app has the calendar available on the home screen all the time. So you can simply swipe up to have a look of the entire calendar events or your goals, which are synchronized with your Google Calendar. And swiping from the blank space gets you the app drawer, where you can search for the application. And it also gets you Google search from the search bar itself. That's all. It's a pretty minimal launcher and it can't get simpler than that. Moving on. And the final launcher in this list is called Launcher. Quite creative. Either way, this is a gesture-based launcher, so everything that you do inside this launcher is based on gestures. On the home screen, it has date and time, nothing else. And you get four shortcuts. Swipe up to bring the app drawer, and swiping from the remaining direction will open a predefined application, which you can change after setting it up. Like I said, this is a gesture-based launcher, so everything that you do is gesture-based only. So you can also add two more gestures like double tap and volume down to trigger an application or an action, but that's pretty much about it. So yeah, these were some of the recently released fresh Android launchers. Let me know which is your favorite one in the comment section below, or which one are you gonna try. As always, it's Mina signing off. Catch you guys in the next one.